Hey, welcome back. It's another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. We'll be joined by Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. This is episode 81, Get Matching Records. Hey, Mike. Well, welcome back. Boy, this is an insane question that was sent in today. Someone has a database here, and they want to be able to choose first name, last name. And you see, for each name, they're in there several times. Want formulas to extract that information, the matching name, and that's crazy. Who would ever try and write formulas for that? I saw this, I said, well, that's obviously, we want to go straight to VBA to do this. And I rearranged things. They had little drop-downs here, but I moved them into this format up here in G1 through H2. And the reason I did that is this format is actually a criteria range for the advanced filter command, And the way that advanced filter would normally work, and I understand advanced filter is hard to do, we would come here, choose a cell in the original data set, go to advanced, and say that our list is in A1 to E10, the criteria range is in G1 to H2, and oh, by the way, copy the matching records to a new location, and that location is going to have just the headings that we want. So I'll scroll over there to J, K, and L, and you'll see that there are the headings. So again, data, advanced, copy, OK, and you see that we get the results. But I understand advanced filter is really hard to use in the user interface. No one likes to use advanced filter. I get it. But I'm not suggesting that we use advanced filter in that way. What I'm suggesting is a little macro that will take the matching records and move them over there. So let's Alt-F11. I already wrote this macro. It's two lines if you want to get right down to it, because this whole line is one line, long line of code that I've broken into multiple lines using the continuation characters that we can see it here on the screen. First thing I do is look for the final row. That's a variable range A1. Hit the N key, hit the down key, and see what row I'm in. That way, if there's more records, it's going to expand. And then from A1, we'll resize out to that final row, five columns, do an advanced filter. We're doing the copy command. We're using the criterion G1 to H2, and we are copying to L or J, K, and L, those three columns, unique equals false. So there's our macro. You know, probably what we should do before we do that is say range, I'll just say J2 to L999.clear. That way it'll clear the previous results. Just thought of that. Okay, so we'll come back here. We want to make that macro easy to run, so that way it's just a single click. I'm going to insert a shape. We'll go with a nice little arrow shape. And right click, assign macro, and after that, okay, all right. Maybe we add a little text box there. Drawing tools, text box. We'll just call it filter. Home, center, good enough. All right, so now what we should be able to do here is we should be able to choose a name, click filter and copy, and all of Paul's records now go over there to the new area. So VBA, a lot faster than trying to figure out a formula, for me anyway. Mike, let's see what you have.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Wow, it has been a long time. I broke my wrist 6 weeks ago. I haven't done any Excel or videos in 6 weeks. And after doing Excel and videos for years and years every day, boy, that's strange. So it's good to be back. I hope I remember how to do this. All right, so here's our criteria. I like the advanced filter. In fact, probably a great way for a VBA idiot like me is to simply turn on the macro recorder and do it that way. All right, so formulas. Formulas, the only advantage to formula maybe is that it immediately changes as soon as you change the criteria. You don't have to click that extra little button, but still, macros, VBA, pretty nice. All right, so our problem is we have two criteria, right? And we have to extract multiple records. So there's four Kens, right? And then if we change it to Paul, there's two records. So we can't do a straight VLOOKUP. Well, there's lots of ways we could do this. I'm going to add an extra column with a formula that will make our formula over here quite a bit easier. What you can do is just use a straight VLOOKUP. Don't have to do an array for you. First, I want a column here. And I want to say have a true or false anytime we have the right names here. So I'm going to use the AND function. I'm going to say anytime one cell to my left is equal to this, and hit the F4 key to lock it, comma. Now, I can't quite get to my second logical test over there, so I'm going to use my arrow keys. Arrow, arrow. That's two cells to my left, anytime that's equal to this, and then F4. Notice those are two logical tests. They come out true or false. When they both come out true, AND delivers a true. Double-click and send it down. Now, we have a bunch of trues and falses. Now, with this alone, we'd have to still have to do an array formula over here. But watch this. I want to convert this basically to 1, 2, 3, 4 here. And then use a straight VLOOKUP over here, looking up the number 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, and I'm going to say this plus that. Now, this won't work because that's text, that x. Anytime you use the plus symbol to add a word and a number, what does it do? It gives you a value error. So that's not going to work. But no problem. I'm going to use the sum function. Sum function is programmed to ignore text. It's exactly like that plus symbol, except for using a built-in function, which is programmed to ignore text. So when it adds, it's just adding the true and the text. Trues are always going to be ones. Falses are always going to be zero. So when I copy this down, boom, I get my 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the duplicates over here won't be a problem. Because here is the first number 4. All of these list 4, but they're not matches. It's only the first 4 we're interested in. No problem. VLOOKUP, we can say do an exact match, and it will ignore. It will only take the first occurrence of the number 4. All right, now I need to figure out how many records are over there. Notice I have that extra column, so I can just say, hey, give me the max. Now, let's just do a straight VLOOKUP. And we're going to have to use, let's do VLOOKUP. Now, our lookup value is going to be 1 for this row, 2 here, 3 here, 4 here, 5, etc. So we're going to use our number incrementer, the formula element rows with an S. Now, I'm sitting in J2, so I say J, and I'm going to lock the row, because this is the rows function. So dollar. All right, so that'll give me 1, 2, 3, 4 as I copy down, comma, and then I simply highlight this whole table, F4 to lock it, comma. Now, column index. Notice this is FN, LN, number, item. Second column, third column, fourth column, fifth column. Well, if rows does 1, 2, 3, 4 as you go down, then columns does 1, 2, 3, 4 as you go to the side. But notice we lock the row there. Here we're going to lock the column. So that J will be locked, but this J will turn to K and then to L, etc. So that gives us 1, 2, 3, 4 as we copy to the side, comma, and then that 0 in the fourth argument for exact match, that'll allow us to avoid those duplicates. Control Enter. That's not going to work. Notice we don't want 1, we want Ken. No problem. F2 to put in edit mode. This columns has given us a 1, but really our first column we're extracting is 2, so I'm going to plus 1. And then copy it over and to the side, copy it down. I know that's a little bit off the screen there. Ah, we got all these horrible NAs. No problem. We're going to use this. Notice 4 is the count. Well, the fourth row, everything after the fourth row needs to show nothing. So I'm going to say equals if. And I'm going to use my same number incrementer. What are we going to say? When rows, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Control V, is greater than our max. And then F4 to lock it. What's true, comma, the value if true. Double quote means show me nothing, comma. And then false is that big VLOOKUP. I come to the end. I close parentheses. Control Enter. Copy it over and double click and send it down. There we go. Now let's test it. Let's change it to Paul. Notice this setup works fine, because when we have two names that don't go together, it shows a 0 and everything's blank over here. But as soon as we change it to Paul, boom, there we go. Wow, that was a wild one to come back on. I'll throw it back over to Mr. Excel.
Mike, that is awesome. I love that formula. All right, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.